Well, I guess we've all got problems
with jobs and bills and tax.
Sometimes you need to find a place
where you feel you can relax.
Yes, 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 no, where can you go? Where can you go to loosen your tie and relax for a while? Where can you go when you're depressed and low? A night of comedy, here we go. We're Pappy's podcast, this is our show.
And I'm Brendan, and together we are
Pappy's Fun Club!
Let's start tonight by looking back over some of our favourite Pappy's Fun Club moments.
I'm Matthew.
I'm Ben.
And I'm Brendan, and together we are
Pappy's Fun Club!
Great memories. Those good are the days.
But first, the show!
What a show it's going to be. Here are some of the acts you can expect to see tonight at the Fun Club.
Sample the delights of The Man Without a Limp.
The stars of Pappy's Fun Club's spin-off sitcom are Four Dads.
Thanks, Dad.
Get a proper job.
Our least popular act, it's Harold Carp. With a disease carrier.
Did we have to book Harold Carr?
Have you not heard? He's a big star now after his cookery show, The Rancid Chef.
It's disgusting. He made phlegm brulee.
The Pappy phone's ringing.
Hello? Guys, it's our mysterious benefactor, Pappy. He's really angry.
Oh, he's always angry.
All right, Pappy, I'll tell them. Pappy says the league tables are out and we've emerged as the worst of all his fun clubs.
The worst?
He can't be worse than Pappy's Fun Club Slovakia. That's just a, it's just a man in a field.
Pappy says our audience figures are at an all-time low.
But I found a way to triple our audience.
Oh, did you make an advert like Pappy suggested?
No, I drew faces onto paper plates and got the audience to wear them on their hands. Look!
That's even better!
Yeah, but Pappy also said that we're wasting too much energy.
What's he talking about? We're energy conscious.
I made this sign.
You don't get it, do you? Pappy says we're wasting so much energy that he holds us directly responsible for the melting of his polar fun cap. If over the course of the show we can't find a more energy efficient way to run the fun club, Pappy says he'll close us down.
What?
Right, we've got to change the way we operate. We can't waste energy in the 21st century.
We're going into the future.
Dude, this is the 21st century.
We're living in the future.
Come on, we didn't join the fun club so we could save the planet. We joined for the rock and roll lifestyle.
Rock and roll lifestyle? Yeah. Look at us. I spent the morning knitting my name on my dad's jumper.
But what about Ben? He's rock and roll. Check him out. He's already chatting up the best looking girl in the audience.
I reckon we stick to what we do best. Having fun. I don't think we can do that and save energy.
Can't we? I've just had an idea. Leave it to me.
On with the show!
Well, our benefactor Pappy is a great supporter of new talent. And that's why each week we kick off the show by giving a brand new act their big break.
And this week is no exception. Let's bring him out now. It's the first time you've seen him. It's the first time we've seen him too. Welcome to the stage, this week's rising star!
Welcome to the show! And you are.
Mm. I have run and I have danced with flowers and with trees. I have tickled fairies and glued them to my knees. I sing songs of adventure all across this mighty land. Yes, I have danced with pixies and buried them in the sand. For I'm a minstrel.
I think all we really wanted was your name.
I'm known as the yodeling alchemist and also as Oberon. Yes, I have gone by many names, but...
Look, what's your name?
John. And I'm a minstrel.
Yes, I know, you've said. Look, I'm sure you're not just here to sing everything you say, so,
With a leg of lamb I shall make a ham and then...
Is this your act? Could you not just tell a joke?
Yes, tell a joke! I tell jokes for no man nor beast except one time with fawns. But that was a night I got so pissed I tossed off a unicorn.
Did you just say you tossed off a unicorn?
I'm a minstrel.
No, never mind. You did. You definitely did. You can't say that on the show. Get this medieval pervert out of here. Go on. Get off. Get off. You can take your foliage with you.
Get out.
No, he's a pervert.
Come on.
That's bestiality. Get rid.
Tom, that did not go well.
Oh, no.
Really didn't. I mean, no wonder our ratings are so bad. Look at this.
If only we were as popular as the other channel. Hang on, that gives me a good idea for our ratings.
But Tom, what are you doing?
Well, if we just show the other channel on this channel, then we'll be sold. People love that.
No, Tom, it doesn't work that way. You can't just show what's on the other channel if that channel's doing better than your channel. It doesn't... Oh.
This is brilliant.
Hello, I'm Len Taunton, and welcome to another episode of Sorry... It's a prank. We've got permission from the council to lower the pavement by just a couple of centimetres. Let's see what happens when this unsuspecting passerby passes by. Oh. I have to ask you, sir, did you enjoy your trip?
Len Taunton!
Sorry, it's a prank!
Oh, brilliant!
Oh, thought something was up.
Isn't it a bother when you get stopped in the street and asked to fill out a survey? It's even more of a bother when it's one of my pranks. Sorry! Excuse me, sir. I wonder if you've got time to fill out this survey.
No, I'm sorry, I'm in a bit of a hurry.
Don't worry, it's not a real survey. Sorry, it's a prank!
Len Taunton! I did not see that coming. Go on then, I'll do the survey.
It's not a real survey. Sorry, it's a prank!
Well, Matthew, can't we watch the advert? I'm waiting to see the trailer for this new horror film. Things that are only scary for a short amount of time.
Yeah, I've heard it's terrifying.
Yeah, but only for a split second. Then it's fine.
No, we haven't.